Well, here's a video, John Myers, Sharpening Iron podcast. Yeah, it's 3 months ago. I rarely go to his channel for anything. There's no point. Calvinist derangement syndrome. I think he has anti-Christian derangement syndrome. Everybody wants to attack or whatever. I've had John Myers, Shouting Iron, make a similar comment on my channel. I've got Calvinist derangement syndrome. He's levelled that accusation at other people who oppose Calvinism, refute it. Certain other channels that I go to. But here's his, what would you call it, damage control. Who's there? Well, the usual suspect, Michel Thurie, a Calvinist. Beckel, obviously a Calvinist. Ryan, shocker. I'm going to address some of the things that he says in this. It's only a short video, so...
There are many people who disagree with Reformed theology, and that's...
Yeah, Reformed theology, Calvinism, Presbyterianism, Arminianism... It's all Calvinism. You know, they will say reform so they can conflate themselves with the Reformation as though Calvinism is a righteous thing or something. No. You know, I don't agree with everything. You know, Luther didn't come far enough out of Catholicism. Calvin certainly didn't, because... The so-called theology of Calvinism, Westminster, London Baptist Confession, blah, blah, the Institutes. It's all Augustinian garbage, essentially Catholic. I do believe, I mean, I would struggle probably to prove it absolutely. I do believe that Calvinism is just another Roman Catholic incursion into the body of Christ to infiltrate it and to mess it up. And it certainly has achieved that in the past to a certain extent. They're still trying to do damage now, Christians, confusing them. Tulip, an absolute pile of tosh. Mainly because the Calvinists generally, they think they can come to an understanding of God's word, scripture, by applying Tulip every time. They will read Tulip into every verse of scripture if they can. And that is called eisegesis. You cannot get to Calvinism. You cannot prove, illustrate, or show Calvinism to be true from the scriptures. KJV. And I don't hate Calvinists. I have been accused of that. I don't. I hate. Maybe I shouldn't use the word hate. I despise Calvinism for its lies, deception, fallacies, straw man arguments. I've had it from this guy here, Beckel. Basically, and I genuinely think Beckel is some sort of cretin. Anyway, let's listen to more of this.
Fine. Okay. I'm not here to convince anyone of Calvinism or anything along those lines.
Rubbish.
I wanted to make this video specifically addressing anti-Calvinists, and I'm not referring to non-Calvinists. I make a strong...
I'm not opposing the Calvinist as such. I'm opposing Calvinism. I want to make that distinction clear. I don't hate Calvinists. Some of them have made me angry. I don't deny it. Calvinism does make me angry because it is false teaching. It's an ideology. It is a cult. It's a personality cult based on Calvin. It's respecter of persons, I would even go as far as to say it's possibly a form of idolatry.
Distinction between someone who denies Calvinism versus someone who hates and consistently misrepresents the Calvinist position.
Well, I've heard you say a few times, John, to Josh Musics, I've got a bit, not much respect for Josh Musics. I think he is a bit of a sycophant. That's why I told him to not email me again a number of weeks ago. I just thought the conversation just isn't going to go. I mean, the egotism is just nearly as bad as Veckel.
Okay. And
I'm against Calvinism, yeah. And I've got no respect for it.
I'll explain why. Non-Calvinists are able to disagree with the Calvinist.
Well, thank you for giving us permission to do so.
And have a charitable conversation with them at the same time.
I've tried that, John. I've tried that. I didn't set out to. I was in a certain person's channel, News Unit. That was months and months ago now. Veckel was in that studio. Rebuke and Reprove was in there. Rebuke and Reprove couldn't stop accusing me of being an Arminian because I rejected Calvinism. Automatically, I became an Arminian. He couldn't stop. That was toxic. That's awful way of dealing with somebody. Veckel ran through the whole gamut of Calvinist false dichotomies, fallacy, and just... I mean, there's no words to describe it. I said I reject Calvinism. I'm just a King James Bible-believing Christian. He obviously didn't like that. So then he called me an Arminian. I can't remember all of the conversation. Then he accused me of being semi-Pelagian, which I rejected. And then he threw the false dichotomy of synergism or monergism. I rejected it. I didn't fully understand why at the time. This is months and months ago, maybe 6 months ago, last year. It was last year. And then he accused me of being a Molinist. I'm not a Molinist. I don't follow Jesuit so-called philosophy. You know, and the whole conversation was just toxic. It was sickening, and they just couldn't stop. And Veckel hasn't stopped referring to me as a rabid remonstrant, or whatever, foaming at the mouth. Oh, I need to stop lying about me. He likes to mimic me and ridicule. And yeah, he's a Calvinist. Just like you, John. You came to my channel saying, you know not of what you speak. Or obviously, that was written on my community tab. I don't know if it's still there. I might have deleted it. Yeah, and we can be polite. It is possible. I tried to be, and with Veckel and Rebuke and Reprove, it's virtually impossible. Sky Out couldn't stop making accusations about me. I've got them on the Me Shorts videos. That guy is another cretin. He actually believes, and this is Sky Out. Sky Out said on the Truth Cartel, that he believes, I should go to that clip really. It's on my channel, just type in Sky Out on the shorts thingy. That Calvin was one of the early church so-called fathers. Literally. And you were blabbering about, yes, we can be polite. And then, you know, earlier in the stream, when you was in there with Josh Musics blabbering at each other, a clash of egos or egotism. You went on about debate dialectics, and you denied. You mentioned double predestination was mentioned. I can't remember precisely the words used. I mean, those people over there, they're so dumb, they don't even realise that the word venerate and the word worship have exactly the same meaning. They are synonymous. And you go on about debate dialectics, which I did mention in a previous video. I didn't do it as a subject heading on a live stream. When you read up on what debate dialectics are, you're obviously using that because it would put things in your favour, sort of. You want your rules. I heard you blabbering with Josh this morning. I don't know whether I'm going to blend this together with the other recording I did. I might not bother. I might just have this separate. Anyway, let's have a listen. I'll move it back a little bit.
Non-Calvinists are able to disagree. The Calvinist. And have a charitable conversation with them at the same time.
Right, so that's true, John. I don't deny that. Please tell me. Talk to Beckle about it secretly in your live stream. I probably won't be there. Ask him about the nature of that conversation I had with him over on News Unit's channel. Rebuke and Reprove was there. And please, if I do come across it, don't lie. That is the basic gist of the whole conversation, you know, compacted down. I'm not avoiding anything. I'm not hiding anything. That conversation made me angry. I was in the live stream. King's Table came in. He actually put me onto a Kevin Thompson video. A video that Kevin Thompson had done, you know, at the end of the stream. I went and listened to it, and really, he absolutely nailed it for me. And since then, I've realised what Calvinism is. Now, I don't hate Calvinists. I've never hated Beckle or Rebuke and Reprove. Before all this occurred, I'd been in a live stream with Rebuke and Reprove discussing, who was he on about? Pine Creek, I think. And that was well over a year ago. I had a basic amount of respect for Beckle when he spoke out against what Smokey says. When Beckle spoke out against what Smokey Saint said about Bill's family, I told Bill that over a year ago, and recently, probably in more recent conversations. So yeah, it is possible, but for some reason, John. And I'm not, you know, I'm not weeping and crying and whatever, right? For some reason, Beckle has got an unbelievably massive bee in his bonnet about me. And yeah, you know, I did ridicule his testimony. Bam! Bam! Right? And I think rightly so. Maybe I could have pulled back from doing it. Other people have ridiculed it. I shared a link to it on Praise I Am side chat loads of times. Beckle didn't like it. Jack Smack thought it was a whole pile of tosh. Other people did. They wouldn't say so in Praise I Am side chat, though, because they're frightened of praise for some stupid reason. Now, I don't hate you, John. I think if we met and we had a cup of tea and a pie, or a pie and a pint, I think we'd get along. I would disagree with Calvinism with you. I think I could possibly have a polite conversation with you. But you need to, I think you need to, apologies for the word, but you need to correct your brothers in Calvinism. I'm never going to acknowledge any Calvinist as being a brother, John. I'll tell you why. Because anybody hearing me say that, not that I'm, you know, the touchstone of anything, anybody hearing me say that would think, especially if they're a novice like Josh Musics and others, they would think, oh, I think this guy is a brother in Christ. Fact is, I don't. I do not believe that you are a brother in Christ, John. Sharpening Iron podcast. You're not sharpening anybody. And the other thing is, John, you know, the novices that you get in the side chat on Praise I Am's channel, they're swallowing a lot of your BS. Oh, not all of them. I mean, you know, people like, what was it, Hudson TD 77 or something, I can't remember precisely. People like Centurion, yes, they'll refute Calvinism. Josh Musics tries to. I don't think he should be using Calvinist terminology as such to refute Calvinism. Just bring them to scripture, I would say, to Josh Musics. Yeah, it is possible to be polite with Calvinists. I do find that Calvinists really aren't capable of being polite with me. I think I would make possibly one exception there. I'm not going to mention the name. No, I'm not going to. So, yeah, I know what the game is with the Calvinists now. The trouble is, you know, John, the Calvinists that I've interacted with, I haven't interacted with you yet, the Calvinists that I have interacted with got me angry. I do admit it. To my shame, I think, possibly. They did me a favour, though, by making me angry, because all that happens when somebody makes me angry, no big deal, there's nothing scary about me, but all that happens when somebody makes me angry, John, is they just focus my attention. When I dig in, I dig in. If you look at my channel, you'll realise I've listened to, and that doesn't make me an expert, at least two, possibly 300 hours of stuff refuting Calvinism. And I've learnt, I would say, a reasonable amount. And I've got to be honest with you, John, not that I would lie, I need to. I don't need to lie. I'm on your case. I know what Calvinism is. It's as bad, if not more evil, than Catholicism. Just as bad as the Jehovah's Witnesses or Seventh-day Adventism. I do believe that Calvinism is egregore. E-G-R-E-G-O-R-E. Perfidious. Fallacy. I think it's evil. I'm not going to lie about it. I've got no reason to lie to anybody. I'm not scared of any of you or anybody. Not you, not Praise, not Dude, not Olive. Those three theological dunces are disgusting. You don't know anything about Praise I Am's channel, John. Sharpening Iron. Not an expert on Praise I Am. But take my word for it. Right. If you upset them the wrong way or the right way, depending on your point of view, you'll get booted out of there so fast. And I know what will happen next. Probably Ryan will send over another Calvinist or a sovereign gracer. I know what the game is over there. Not perfectly. I don't like to see people get kicked in the teeth, John. And you have had a bit of that from Dude. Layman's Seminary, another example, you know. I mean, it is a fact. I don't like to see anybody get kicked in the teeth, regardless of who they are. William Freeman got it from Dude the other day, over the weekend, I think, or could have been last Friday or something. So I'm not virtue signalling. I'm not the slightest bit scared of you either, John. I don't hate you. I think you need to do something with that beard, though. It looks weird. Well, it's about if you just had the moustache or something. But, I mean, that's not... not that it matters.
Non-Calvinists are able to disagree
with
the Calvinist.
Yeah.
And have a charitable conversation with them at the same time.
Yeah, wouldn't that be good? Wouldn't that be great? Okay.
That is a very real possibility.
Yeah, oh,
I've had many conversations with non-Calvinists.
Yeah, let me know when that's going to happen. Let me know when that's going to happen, John.
Yes. They have been very fruitful.
Yeah, well, you know, possibly.
Problem becomes when the alleged non-Calvinist attributes motive...
Hold on. Alleged non-Calvinist. I am definitely not a Calvinist. I'm not a Provisionist. I'm not Arminian. I'm not a Synergist. I'm not Semi-Pelagian. Right? I'm not Arminian. Alleged.
Problem becomes when the alleged non-Calvinist attributes motive to the Calvinist.
No. Are you saying then there's a possibility that you have no motive for whatever it is you do and say? Yeah. Once you learn what Calvinism is, I'm not expert on it, mind. I'd love to know what books you've got on your shelf there, by the way. Once you learn what Calvinism is, regardless of who it is or whatever, right, and you listen to the way that they communicate and interact with others on certain live streams, yeah, praise I am, and others, right, Veckel, Rebuke and Reprove, Ryan, yeah, Motive, come on, don't be disingenuous now. Because I'm motivated. You're motivated, John. The only thing I want to refute is Calvinism. I don't want to motivate you as far as Calvinism goes. That's why I won't call you a brother. I don't like it when you refer to genuine Christians as brother. I think that's a deception. You may not be doing it on purpose. Perhaps you don't realise that that's how it comes across. Motive, of course.
Yeah, we're just here to deceive. We're here to become your best bud.
I don't think that you're setting out to deceive. I would say that's true of some of you Calvinists. I don't know. I don't think so. I think you probably genuinely believe the Calvinist garbage. The problem is, John, you don't realise that, on my view, you are deceived and you're deceiving others. Yeah, you believe in Calvinism, you believe in the Reformed so-called theology, London Baptist, Westminster Baptist Confession and the other so-called confessions, Tulip, you know. I don't think you're setting out to lie. I just think that Calvinism in itself, regardless of who it is, Calvinism looked at objectively as far as possible is a deception, a lie. You cannot compact down all of Scripture, right, into five ideological claims, propositions. And, you know, use Tulip as a lens through which you read scripture, which is eisegesis. You're brainwashed. You've brainwashed yourself.
Attributes motive to the Calvinist.
No.
Now we're just here.
No.
To deceive. We're here to become your best bud so that.
Well, you do keep calling everybody brother in that channel. That's up to you. You know, they don't say anything against it. You know, I'm not whinging, crying about it. I see it differently to you, John. Maybe you are a friendly, kindly, nice person. It's not about you as such. It's about Calvinism. I don't want people to be infected by it, poisoned by it. It is. It's a parasite on the body of Christ, trying to insert itself into the body of Christ by conflation, pseudo-philosophical, so-called reasoning, other fallacies, false dichotomies, stupid analogies and theoreticals. Analogies. It slipped my mind. It'll come back to me. Hypotheticals, yeah, sorry. Yeah.
Think that they're your friend, but they're really trying to deceive you.
Well, you may be friendly. Type of idea. You might well be friendly, genuinely, towards some people over there. Maybe you do like them. I don't care. I don't care about personalities in this. I'm only interested in exposing Calvinism for what it is. If in all the time that I've done these videos recording, made my own perhaps stupid comments, if you want to say that, about Calvinism, the things that I've learned, if I only ever managed through prayer, reading and, you know, pointing out things to convince one person to leave Calvinism, I will be a very happy person. Once people realize what Calvinism is, especially the Bible-believing Christians, I mean, if they truly believe the Bible, they're not going to accept Calvinism anyway. It just won't make sense to them. It will just seem contradictory. And yeah, quite a few people are getting on it in Praise I Am. Well, not that many, but not because of Praise I Am. I still think Praise I Am is basically Calvinist or Catholic. I don't know. One or the other, both probably. The guy's an idiot. I mean, he tried to refute Sam Shamoon by going to a Calvinist website. The guy's an idiot. I'm just wondering, John, if you actually would have laughed at that. Oh, he's arguing against Sam Shamoon, the Catholic, the nutty Mary Ollator, blah, blah, right? And he goes to a Calvinist website, calm. Yeah. That would be funny if it wasn't so ridiculous.
And essentially refuse to accurately represent them. As repeatedly...
John. I've heard you a number of times say, oh, you're so confused about Calvinism. You don't really understand. Or you're missing my point. Or it's a category error. Things like that. According to you, every one of you Calvinists, we non-Calvinists, never understand. Oh, you poor so, you just don't understand Calvinism. Oh, yeah. No, it's not working, Josh. Why do I keep calling him Josh? Sorry. I didn't mean to insult you, John. It's not working, John. Seriously. You Calvinists, I get the impression you're not capable of examining yourselves. Self-examination much. Much like dude. He thinks he's so righteous, and then he treats people like utter garbage and filth. Same with praise I am. And then they extol the virtues of being polite and kindly, charitable and loving. Oh, yes. Praise I am is anointed. He has seen the Holy Spirit. According to praise I am and dude and Olive. In fact, according to Olive, this isn't about praise I am, mind. According to Olive, praise I am has perfected the art of patience. And some other stuff, I can't remember. Anyway, here we go. I'm only 2 minutes in and I've been talking for about half hour.
Over and over and over, you will hear from them. Well, no, you're just here to deceive us. You don't have anything meaningful.
I don't think every Calvinist... I don't think Calvinists are setting out to deceive purposely, because that would imply that they know that what they believe is a lie, is false. And I actually think that the Calvinist who's bought into Calvinism proper actually believes Calvin, Calvinism, Tulip. So the Calvinist actually does believe what they're doing, what they're saying. Because if they didn't, they would have their own, they would notice, hopefully, contradiction, inconsistency, right? Calvinists believe the garbage that they've been taught to believe. So I don't think they're setting out to lie. I just think Calvinism is a lie of the devil. It is a work of Satan, and you Calvinists don't realize it. So you're misrepresenting those that oppose Calvinism, John. I think could be wrong.
To say, and I have heard this out of the horse's mouth.
Oh,
numerous
yeah.
times.
All right. Late.
Okay. So I want to play a clip for you guys. And this is from my brother's stream. A good friend of mine. I'm very thankful for him. He's Oriental Orthodox. So I strongly disagree with him. But he and I are very, very good friends and have good conversations.
I'm going to guess it, because I haven't watched this video already yet. It could be I'm not what I'm not. As soon as he mentioned Eastern Orthodox, I thought, yeah, it must be him. I think. Let's have a look.
With each other. So I appreciate our brother in the midst of our differences.
Your brother.
And your he will be brother. Playing a clip by this guy named Dude.
Oh,
on him. The live stream. He goes by Dude.
Yeah. Oh, I know.
I don't know much about him.
That one, I genuinely did not expect him to say dude. He has had pushback from dude, though. I do remember that. I thought it was because he said Eastern Orthodox or something. I thought, yeah, it must be I'm not what I'm not. Just pull it back 10 seconds.
I appreciate our brother in the midst of our differences.
Your brother, okay.
And he will be playing a clip by this guy named Dude.
Oh, yeah.
On the live stream.
Huh?
He goes by Dude.
Yeah. He's a pig.
I don't know much about him.
To be honest, I don't know that much about him. I know he is a disgusting pig. I've never really... And I'm not saying this because of recent events. I've never really truly appreciated his presence in my live stream. In fact, he did come in a live stream last year, right? Which I didn't delete. I just made it private. And the whole thing, I mean, just nauseating. I don't know what the guy thinks he is. I believe he is an empty vessel, but there you go.
But I've had interactions with him myself.
Oh, yeah, I've seen. I've heard.
And I will expound upon those in a moment.
Okay, go on then.
But I want to play this clip.
Yeah.
Because he's interacting with Josh, who agrees with him.
Yeah.
Soteriologically.
Yeah.
So he's a free gracer. He agrees with basically everything that this dude guy believes.
So that's Josh and dude. I wasn't expecting him to mention Josh Music. I thought he was, because John here, Sharpening Iron, has had interactions with dude that were not pleasant. Yeah, okay then, let's see what his point is.
When it comes to soteriology, right. They are not in disagreement.
Okay.
Because he is nice to the Calvinist,
because he's
willing to have a dialogue with brothers and sisters who are Calvinists, which I appreciate him for.
Your brothers and sisters, not mine, not Josh Music's. I'm not trying to speak for that clown. Beg your pardon. I don't acknowledge any Calvinist, male or female, as brother or sister. Ever. I won't.
And Josh, if you're watching, I love you, brother.
Oh, yeah. He's and, not your you brother. Know, give
obviously,
over.
We're going to have strong and heartfelt disagreements. But I love our brother, and we can have fruitful conversations. And
yeah, right.
We've had those conversations before.
Not so much recently. But
he says, because you are nice to the Calvinist, you are being a gospel compromiser.
Yeah.
You are the enemy because you're associating with those Calvinist heretics.
Yeah.
Okay. So let me bring this up so you guys can see this clip. It is quite astonishing.
I don't know.
To be perfectly honest with you guys. It is very, very astonishing. So let me...
I'm not astonished.
Fix the screen.
I am not the slightest bit astonished. I know what dude's like. He is a pig. Basically, if you don't like my terminology, I can't think of a better word. Do I remember this stream? Probably. This might remind me.
Really quick. Okay, that's not it.
Oh, come on.
Welp. Let's try this one. Okay, that one works. Here is our brother on the left. He's about to play the clip.
Your brother?
Josh is on the bottom left.
Oh,
the dude guy's at the top.
I see now. This was on I'm Not Where I'm Not's channel. He was doing a review of Praise's live stream. He's the Eastern. That guy, I'm Not Where I'm Not, is an Eastern Orthodox Calvinist. Yeah, ooh, what a mess. What a mix-up.
Right. Those are the two that were interacting. And this is what dude has to say to Brother Josh.
It's not your brother. Issue.
Listen to it yourself.
What's your deal, man?
Well, I'm just, like, you're coming in here, and I've seen you doing it before. You play patty cake, trying to play nice with people who corrupt the gospel. And to me, that makes you an enemy of the gospel almost. You realize that, right? Like when you're trying to play nice with a bunch of people who are hell-bent on corrupting the gospel, being like, yeah, they're fine. They're okay. I'm going to myself, yeah, there might be nice people. Like I as a person, they're nice, but they're ass backwards inside out when it comes to defending even evangelizing the gospel of Christ.
Forgive me for the language that was just used there.
Why would you need to be forgiven?
This is the type of behavior.
Stop virtue signaling, John. It doesn't work.
That you get from anti-Calvinists, where if you just have a conversation that is fruitful with the Calvinist, oh, you're a gospel compromiser. You guys catch that? Because Josh had a fruitful conversation with a Calvinist. He's a gospel convert.
Calvinism does compromise the gospel. The Calvinist believes in prevenient grace. Apparently you need to be regenerated before you can believe, which is just literally, as dude said, ass backwards. Twisted out of shape. I will never call you a brother. The Calvinist that I've interacted with, more specifically Veckel, I think he hates me. And I don't care.
Compromiser. He's the enemy. He's playing patty cake with the devil.
Yeah.
What do you do with this type of imbalance that you are so upset at Calvinism that you're unwilling to admit your own pride and arrogance?
Yeah, he can't, because he is prideful and arrogant and presumptuous, intensely egotistical. And I would say that dude is an empty vessel. I would never in a billion years send anybody to him for doctrine. He is just simply a nasty individual. He doesn't know it. He doesn't even realize it. He doesn't self-examine.
I just don't understand.
Why would you?
He will attribute motive.
Yeah.
He will attribute all of these deceiving ideologies to the Calvinist.
Yeah.
Simply because he disagrees with them.
No, Calvinism. I don't give a stuff what dude says now anyway. Particularly, it's just meaningless. Calvinism is an ideology. It's a cult. It's an egregore. It is evil. It's just that you Calvinists can't see it. You don't realize it. You don't comprehend it. You're brainwashed with it. You brainwashed yourselves. Calvinism is a lie of the devil.
They're hell-bent on disrupting and deceiving the gospel of Jesus Christ.
Listen, don't use your body language to emphasize or prove your point. That's not working either. Is that a vocal or a visual fallacy of some sort? Indicate heaven with your finger and talking with your feet.
He was to hear me on the streets. He and I would be preaching the same gospel.
And then what? You would bring them into Calvinism, wouldn't you, John? Wouldn't you? They came round to your, or they would probably, if they got apparently converted, right? One of the elect. They would probably see you in town again. Oh, yeah, you know, they would ask you probably even when they got converted that day or something like that. Oh, which, you know, so-called church do you go to? Oh, I go here, blah, blah, this street. I'll be there on such and such and, you know, lovey-dovey. And then you'll suck them right into Calvinism. Most of the time, though, people only become Calvinist after they genuinely became Christian and got saved. It's just that, unfortunately, I mean, the Baptist so-called church in America, is it IFB or whatever they call it, is infiltrated by Calvinists. So the Christian who lacks discernment may well get sucked into Calvinism. They will literally be recruited. And I do not use the word recruited. No, I mean recruited. I mean, I don't try to use that word in a nasty way, but Calvinists are usually recruited. I'm still not going to refer to any Calvinist as a brother. I did ask John here for his testimony. He didn't give it me. He thinks he did. All he did was quote scripture, which is fine. I've no problem with that, of course. He still didn't tell me what his testimony is, how he got saved, when, the circumstances, blah, blah. Oh, Veckle did, because he was in the kitchen sorting out his cutlery. Matthew 7, 21 to 23. Bam! 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 Oh, dear.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh, dear. Oh, John shook his head in exasperation. Oh. And indicated heaven with his finger.
Same gospel that Jesus
he's wagging his finger now. Oh, John, please do not do that to us all.
Is God incarnate, lived a perfect and sinless life.
Yeah,
he bore our transgressions on the cross, he died, was buried, and he rose again on the third day. And he ascended into heaven and is at the right hand of God the Father, interceding for those who are his. And everyone who puts their trust in the person or work of Jesus Christ will find him to be nothing other than a perfect Savior. That's the gospel. But no, we're perverting it.
You pervert it with your Calvinism. Do you believe in prevenient grace, John? What about total depravity, total inability, unconditional election, limited atonement, irresistible grace, perseverance of the saints? It's all exhaustive causal determinism, meticulous causal determinism. You add to the gospel and basically pervert it, especially with, well, not especially, prevenient grace, irresistible grace. All the, how many different types of grace are there in Calvinism? There's at least four that I can think of. Oh, he's got his hand on his heart. Oh, that's proof of sincerity. Oh, I shall weep now.
Even though we proclaim the same gospel. This is anti-Calvinism at its finest.
That they use the same words. They have to. They're not going to make themselves obvious, which is the deceptive part, really. I don't think I've ever seen... Do Calvinists actually preach on the street? They might do in America. But are they going to say... Are they going to be honest about being a Calvinist? You know, are they going to say, not that most people understand Calvinism as non-believers, atheists, blah, blah. But are they going to say, you know, if they're preaching, whatever, oh, yeah, you know, you're a Calvinist and blah, blah. No, I don't think they are. I mean, even Satan believes that Jesus Christ died, was buried, resurrected third day, and seated at the right hand of the Father. Oh, yeah. Oh, he knows all right. And so do the Calvinists. I don't think the Calvinists believe the gospel, really. They believe Calvin. Calvinism takes precedence. Right. They were elected before the foundation of the world. So on Calvinism, they do not need the cross. They do not need what Christ accomplished on the cross at Calvary. paid the penalty and price for our sins and things. No, because the Calvinist, on Calvinism, they were predestined before the foundation of the world. Double predestination, infant damnation, meticulous, exhaustive causal determinism. It's universalism. They don't need Jesus Christ, really. They just need to be elect. Yet Calvinism, absolute lie of the devil, really is.
That is why I am coining the term Calvinist derangement syndrome.
Yeah, I think you have that. You are a Calvinist, and you have a derangement syndrome. And that derangement syndrome is called Calvinism. That's what it does to you. I've noticed it, John. Once you buy fully into Calvinism, it's like you go into this loop of so-called of reasoning, circular reasoning, conflation, peer pressure, an epistemic ranking criteria. I mean, you're going to find it very difficult to come out of Calvinism, especially when you're surrounded by Calvinists, because you know they're going to ridicule you if you were to leave Calvinism, and you know that you're going to look a fool if you, like, sort of went over to Praise's channel and said, I reject Calvinism, blah, blah, and, you know, this, that, and the other. Ryan, Veckle, Rebuke and Reprove, Sky Out, Cinecog, they're going to dump all over you. I think that they will all treat you like garbage. They will argue at you, backbite you, and, you know, they will blabber into your ear continually. Rebuke and Reprove, he's absolutely nauseating. The guy's an idiot. In fact, I think Calvinism turns Calvinists basically into fools. Literally, fools, self-deceived and deceiving others. That's what it is. That's what it does. If only there was some way, I mean, I'll have to pray for you and things like that, John. You need to step back from it and look at it. Is it biblical? Is it based on scripture? And I'm confident that you're going to think it is, when it isn't. You're reading Calvinism into scripture, John, KJV. You probably use the ESV, which is a Calvinist contraption done by Wayne Grudem. Or you might use the Legacy Standard so-called Bible, which was paid for by John MacArthur. I think you're going to find it very hard to escape that egregore of Calvinism, John. You are self-brainwashed. You brainwashed yourself with it. Once you bought into it, that, you know, you cannot hear objections to it without, like, strawmanning people. Begging the question. We say the same things about you as you postulate about us. Begging the question, John. Me personally, though, speaking objectively, I genuinely don't think it's possible to have any kind of reasonable conversation with a Calvinist. I, they made me angry. Yeah, I'm not, like, sat in my flat crying and weeping every day about that. I'm not rabid. I'm not a remonstrant. I'm not Arminian. No, I don't live in Turkey. I'm not Arminian. I'm not a synergist. I gave my testimony on Praise's channel to Veckle. What did, you know, he said it was, what was it? Oh, that was fantastic. Oh, that was brilliant or something. And I said to him, I am not a synergist. What does Beckel keep doing? Keeps calling me a synergist, a rabid remonstrant. Foaming at the mouth. All sorts of other childish rubbish. And you won't speak against that kind of behaviour, will you, John? Not that I would expect you to, and I guarantee I will never ask you to. It's just that I've noticed that you don't. Hold on. Someone's knocking at my door. I lost my thread a little bit.
Okay.
I knock on the door.
Calvinist.
One of the cleaning ladies in the building I live in needed to borrow some electricity, if you know what I mean. So I'm just going to remind myself.
Coining the term derangement syndrome.
Yeah, I think the Calvinist has the syndrome of derangement and question begging the question. They think possibly the same thing as we do about them. We're reading into each other what they're doing, what they're saying. Motivation. Where, I mean, for me personally, I'm peeping behind the curtain wherever I can. You know, not to I don't seek to lie about them. They are deceitful. They do use a lot of fallacy, the Calvinist. And I do think Calvinism is deranged. It's funny, actually, it's sort of ironic, you know, the Calvinist will accuse Christians of the very thing that they are. I've been accused of being a synergist or a provisionist, right, by two different people. Calvinism is synergism. I will be watching that video later. I've never been a provisionist. Provisionism is juvenile thinking. It's ideological. I think that the only person that should be defending provisionism is Leighton Flowers, who created that acronym. I don't want anything to do with it. I don't want anything to do with it at all. Hold on.
Okay.
Still indicating heaven with his fingers now. He looks very papal. Oh, yes.
Calvinist derangement syndrome.
Yes.
That is not a pejorative, guys.
Oh.
I'm not trying to be rude to them.
Not a pejorative, and yet it is. He's actually saying, those that oppose Calvinism to the extreme that he perhaps doesn't like is deranged. Okay, love, hold on. So calling someone deranged, that's hardly polite, is it? It's not very cordial. That's a word I keep hearing on Praise Am Channel, you know, cordiality, being cordial. You know, it sounds like a weak lemon drink. Being cordial on Praise Am Channel, I have to say, is a very, very high expectation over there. They are far from it, as Sparrow has recently experienced. You've already experienced that, John, sharpening iron. Dude, he doesn't have any objection to making threats. He has no objection to lying about people, neither does Praise. I've seen recordings, heard recordings of Praise threatening, I think it was Jay Patchick. Very nasty. Praise will turn on his best friends. A person who lives in New Zealand, I think it's South Island or North Island, I don't think it matters. Praise I am, is that dumb Although, I mean, you know, I'm not doing. I mean, where's the common sense in posting a laptop from USA to New Zealand? I mean, I was going to send half a pound, not even that, 300 or 400 grams worth of biscuits, you know, to somebody in Australia. It would have cost me £30. At least ten times more than the actual cost of the items inside the box. Right? And he posted the laptop to New Zealand to Gavin Hurlman. That's up to him. I'm not complaining. They were very close friends. As soon as he disagreed, praise I am spent weeks and weeks ridiculing Gavin, his family, his marriage, his divorce settlement, everything he could. Right? He's done it with other people. He's done it with Ryan the Presbyterian, your colleague. He's done it with me. They can't stop on that channel. It's a pigsty. And frankly, I think you belong over there, John, sometimes, you know, with Josh Music's The Sycophant. You know, they buy into these lies about me. Dude calling me a provisionist. Absolutely stupid. The guy's a fool. An empty vessel. You carry on over there, John. Don't call me deranged. I'm not. And because somebody doesn't agree with Calvinism stronger than you like or appreciate or whatever, they are deranged. Yeah. Yeah. You're deranged if you believe that, John. Here we go. There's only 2 minutes left. Two and a half minutes left.
It's simply the fact that they are so strongly against the Calvinist. Yeah. That they're unwilling to even
category error. Some people may well be against the Calvinist. No, I'm against Calvinism. I despise Calvinism. It is the work of the devil. You're playing games with words again, John. Don't do it. Not with me. Right. It's not working, lad. It's not working. I've been a Christian 32 years, lad. You're not fooling me. Not for long. Especially if somebody gets me angry on a particular theological issue. I will certainly focus my attention on it if I haven't, sort of come across it before. I've never... Oh, I'm not going to go into that.
I'm going to have a meaningful conversation with them, lest they be considered a gospel compromiser.
That's what Calvinism does. That is the, well, not the main undercurrent, one of the undercurrents, one of the entailments of Calvinism is that Calvinism undermines the gospel, the true gospel, based on scripture, God's word, KJV, I say, right? The Calvinist does not need the gospel. Check out the links I put under this video when I put it live on my channel. It's up to you. I mean, if you do or you don't, it's up to you, you know? I don't hate John Myers. I like the guy. I was going to invite him into my studio. I don't think it's a good idea. I wouldn't mind privately discussing things with him. This video in particular, possibly. No, I've got no real objection to talking to him. Debates, I don't think I'm very good at debates. Because people know, I think mostly people know that over-talking me, filibustering is absolute kryptonite to me. I never realised that before. I'm sort of working on it, praying about it. I will be, yeah. See, Veckel, is that moral? even thinks he knows what my prayer life is like. See what I mean? He's deranged with his own Calvinism. He's a compatibilist. Compatibilism is incoherent. It does not make sense. It's a contradiction. Weckl is a well-known moron, basically, I would say. Not completely a moron. But it's the best example. I hate to use the word, but I do apologise. He is the best example of moronicy on YouTube. In fact, the funny thing is, I've come to like, believe it or not, I've come to like Illuminati Land. As well as you can do when you read their comments in the side chat. Yeah, I like him. Yeah. That which I find quite funny. And he is quite funny as well, you know. But I'm able to be reasonable with people. In other words, you know, reasonable, able to reason. Weckl is not capable of it. He doesn't even know what an inference is. Anyway, this isn't about Weckl, although he's down there. I don't know if any more comments. There's only 5 comments there. All Calvinists. No Christians have been there. Just these people. I don't know who Stars or Angels is. Anyway, here we go.
That's Calvinist derangement syndrome. Guys, you can be a non-Calvinist and realize how foolish of a statement dude just made. That is so foolish.
And we I don't give a stuff what dude says, right, and I don't care who it is. If they've told the truth, it has to be admitted to, regardless of my opinion of that person. And he is correct on that. He's very correct on it. Calvinism does corrupt the gospel of Jesus Christ. The Calvinist does not need the gospel. They don't need Jesus, essentially.
Have to turn away from it. That type of mentality will void the Christian of any fruitful conversations and iron sharpening iron, as as the proverb says in Proverbs 27:17.
You're not sharpening anybody, you're just making people realize that Calvinism really is poison. And I'm going to try not to comment anymore. I didn't want this video to be that long. I mean, this is 11 minutes 50 seconds, 11 minutes 45 seconds. And I've been on it for about 1 hour and 8 minutes. It's so loaded with garbage, really.
How exactly are you supposed to do that if you call everyone who disagrees with you?
It's not a case.
Bunch of gospel deniers. You can't.
No, you're. Is that some sort of fallacy there? Everybody who disagrees with you. No, what you were referring to is everybody who disagrees with Calvinism, right, which is one category. It is a category error, I think. Correct me if I'm wrong. And you're and then a category of people who disagree with you. No, that is a fallacy.
Do not do that, guys. Don't.
All right.
Don't become a Calvinist. You don't need to, okay? I'm not here to convince you of Calvinism.
You're a liar. You keep going on about Calvinism. I've heard you. I've seen you. I called you out on it months and months ago. You were trying to pull them into prevenient grace. I think I might have even been in the studio and I pointed it out. I knew what was coming. You're always trying it on, John. Be honest with yourself, if not with anybody else, please.
To just give the Calvinist perspective. But don't do that. Okay.
All right. He's telling us what to do now. And he's indicating heaven with his fingers again. Yeah, all right.
Calvinist derangement syndrome on the max.
Yeah, you're deranged, apparently. Yeah, right. Okay.
Do not do that, guys.
All right.
Let's seek to honor and glorify God.
Oh, yeah.
In everything that we do.
Oh.
And we can't do that when we're behaving like...
We. Don't conflate everybody else with you. I understand what you're saying. You're not interested in glorifying God. You're interested in glorifying Calvinism, or Calvin, or Tulip, all three. And the small g God of Calvinism is not sovereign in all domains. The small g God of Calvinism is not sovereign in the domain of free will. And don't argue for free will. Just pull them into scripture. Show me free will in scripture. Unless you're on about free will offerings. Don't get in a debate on free will with them, because it's not in scripture, and, you know, other reasons.
That. Let this be a lesson.
Oh, yes.
And a warning to all of us.
Oh, a warning to all of us. Bring us all in. Yes, we're all part of whatever it is you think you're going on about, indicating heaven with your finger. Let us all glorify the small g God of Calvinism. No thanks. I'm never going to call you brother while you're a Calvinist, while you admit to being Reformed, Calvinist, Presbyterian. It isn't personal, it's just... I won't do it. No. Can't. I should never do that.
To turn away from this mindset and to look to Christ.
Yeah.
And to have humility and patience and charity in our discussions.
Yeah, I agree with being charitable. That is the last thing that the Calvinists I've interacted with have been. They have not been charitable. Yeah, well, basically what John here is suggesting that you do is just open the door. Oh, welcome the Calvinists in, because they want to infiltrate. They're always doing it in the Baptist IFB or whatever over in the USA. I think they're doing it over here. Bill did mention that they've been doing that. Just invite them all in. Light a candle and let us all have a hug. Let us all hug each other. Oh, joy. Yeah, no thanks. No thank you.
You can't have charity in a conversation when you're just looking at someone and saying, oh, you're just here to try to deceive me.
You can't
That's
blame
not how you have Christian charity. You will never find that.
You can't blame them for seeing it that way. You really can't. Yeah, we could be more charitable, sort of loving towards you. And yeah, there's no need for the nasty rudeness and stuff. Veckle, rebuke and reprove, Jill, Ryan even has been slightly rude towards me, calling me some sort of wide-eyed, whatever. I don't know what he really meant. I don't know. American euphemisms, I'm not interested in learning them.
As the biblical definition of charity. Ever. In order to...
The Calvinist does not believe scripture, KJV. They do not. They think they need Calvin to interpret it for you through the lens of Tulip. These Calvinists, they will moralize you, moralize at you all day. Oh, you do not understand. You know not of what you speak. Peace. Peace. Oh, you just deranged. Yeah. Yeah, no, thank you.
To have true charity,
no,
you right. must Here we go. Treat each other equally.
Oh, no. No.
And that is what is done in this case.
All right.
May God be glorified. Soli Deo Gloria.
Now, that's interesting, isn't it? Soli Deo Gloria. I did a video about that once, I think, or I mentioned it during a live stream. Soli Deo Gloria. Why go to the Latin? Deo Gloria, God, you know, Deo Gloria, which is a feminine noun. You've heard the name of a woman, Gloria. Is it a female so-called deity that these Calvinists, you know, all glory, only glory, Gloria of the feminine so-called deity, small g, God of Calvinism. Do you get where I'm going with that? Why do you need Latin? As I said earlier, I think, in this recording, Calvinism is just Catholic, Augustinian, Gnostic, Manichaeism, Synergism, even Platonism. Seriously, oh yes, he's closing his eyes in exasperation. Yeah. Thanks for the moralizing, John. Yeah, it's so germane. It's so Calvinist of you. As I say, I don't hate you. You probably, you know, if I met you, as I said, you know, like Kevin's Biblical Discussions did with Veckel. Veckel did say, oh yes, but of course I've got an agenda. Don't deny it, Veckel, please. I was there. I was at that stream when he was discussing it with Kevin, you know, meeting up in, is it New York somewhere? Quiche, pizza, you know, a cup of coffee, a good chat. Yeah, you know, great. And you, Veckel, you said, oh yes, you know, I can't remember precisely his words, but you have an agenda. Of course you've got an agenda, Veckel. And your agenda was always pushing Calvinism. Yeah. You think people forget stuff, don't you? And yeah, I found that video of you with Jack Angstreich blabbering about adultery. You know, if you thought you could get away with it and whatever. It's on my channel. It uploaded recently. I think I'll call it a day here. I mean, wow. You know, 11 minutes, 45 second video, and I've done, what, 1 hour and 18 minutes. Yeah, believe in the Lord Jesus Christ. He is the only means of salvation. Acts 4:12. No man can come to a Father but by Jesus Christ. He's the only person on this earth that is ever to be believed. His word, he is the word made flesh, God manifest in the flesh, the Lord Jesus Christ. I would encourage you Calvinists to get saved. I do not accept any Calvinist as brother or sister. Calvinism is not salvific. Elected before the foundation of the world? No. Because it cuts out everything after the foundation of the world, doesn't it? Exhaustive or meticulous causal determinism destroys epistemology, knowledge, types of knowledge. A Calvinist does not believe the scripture. You want to refute a Calvinist? Pull them to Scripture. Don't use their terminology. Sovereign. Free will. You know, compatibilism. You're wasting your time. Anyway, that's it. I'm going. Bye. And anybody who lies about another person, whether they're Christian or whatever, the Lord rebuke you, Satan, for your lies, in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Yeah, Jesus Christ is the Lord.